morning, everybody. Today I am going to talk about the classification and description of distinct sounds. You always have heard about consonants and vowels. There are vowels, five vowels, and there are only one consonant. But linguistically, when we study, it's totally different. This is the diagram of oral contents of the speech. Next. Speech sounds are very broadly divided into two categories, namely vowels and consonants. Consonants, when we produce the sound represented by the letter sh in the word shoe, we realize that during the production of this sound, the air escapes through the mouth with friction. Means, whenever we speak, whenever we pronounce any consonant sound, we hear the friction sound. All sounds during the production of which we hear friction are consonants. But not all consonants are produced with friction. Now vowels. As I have already given the example of shoe, when we produce the sound represented by the letters OE means O in the word shoe, the air escapes through the mouth freely and we do not hear any kind of friction. Means whenever we pronounce vowel, we don't hear any kind of friction. All the sounds during the production of which we do not hear any friction are called vowels. Next. Now, description of consonants. Consonants can be divided under the category of, under two categories. First is the place of articulation and the second is manner of articulation. Place of articulation means what are the organs that are involved in the production of any consonant is called the place of articulation, and the manner in which these sounds are pronounced is called the manner of articulation. Manner of articulation refers to the structure involved. Structure here means restriction, the restriction of air. Next. Restriction of consonants. Place of articulation means the two articulators involved in the production of the consonant. Means any sound when we pronounce, there are two articulators or two organs are involved. And these two organs are called articulators. The places of articulation that frequently come in words are the following. Next, first is bilabial. Bilabial, as the name suggests, bi means two and labial means lips. The two lips are the articulators. Both the articulators are radio articulators. The initial sounds in the English word bi, bi, and mi. Sounds are, see how we pronounce these consonants? Ba, and ma. Means both the lips are involved. Next is radiodental. Labial articulator is the lower lip and the basic articulators are the upper front teeth. The initial sounds in the English words fine and fine. Whenever we pronounce these two sounds, what we hear? Ba, we will pronounce like this, where ba means lower lip is touching the upper front teeth. And ba sound. Dental. The tip of the tongue is the active articulator and the upper front teeth are the passive articulators. Here we have two sounds, th and the. Here what we find that the tip of the tongue is touching the upper front teeth. So how will we pronounce? Th and the. Hence, alveolar. The tip or blade of the tongue is the active articulator and the teeth ridge is the passive articulator. The initial sounds in the English word, in the English words, tin, bin, near, sip, zip, and the sounds are da, da, na, sa, za, and la. Here, whenever we pronounce these sounds, what we find that the tip of the tongue is touching the active articulator and the teeth ridge. Next, post alveolar. Alveolar means teeth ridge. So just the back part of the teeth ridge, means the tip of the tongue is the active articulator and the part of the roof of the mouth that lies immediately behind the teeth ridge is the passive articulator. The sound represented by the letter R in the English words, try and try, is an example of a post-alveolar sound. Next, caliper. The front combination sound in English word yes is an example of a palatal sound. Here sound is see here it just it is written like J sound of English, but it is pronounced here. Next velar. The back of the tongue is the active articulator and the soft palate is the passive articulator. Whenever you pronounce these sounds k, g, and ng, you can hear some sound here when you touch your fingers here. Next, glottal. Glottal sounds are produced at the glottis and the two vocal cords are the articulator. Glottis here it is present and the initial sound of the English word head is an example of a glottal sound. Whenever you pronounce kh sound, you can hear a kind of vibration here. So this is called glottal sound. Thank you.